एमकॉम जनरल एंड एफए सेकंड सेमिस्टर ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल थियरी एंड बिहेवियर सेकंड यूनिट परसेप्शन। परसेप्शन इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ रिसीविंग इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द वर्ल्ड एंड मेकिंग सेंस अराउंड अस। इट इन्वॉल्व्स डिसाइडिंग विच इंफॉर्मेशन टू नोटिस। Perception includes all those processes by which an individual receives information about the environment. Seeing, hearing, feeling, tasting, and smelling the objects or events being perceived. The environment in which perception occurs and the individual doing the perceiving. Perception process. Human beings are constantly attacked by numerous sensory stimulations, including sight, smell, taste, etc. The crucial question in the study of perception is why the same universe is viewed differently persons. The question is the perception. The answer is the perception. Different people perceive the universe differently. So according to this, stumbly, attention, recognition, translation, satisfaction, performance and behavior. So according to this, stumbly, the receipt of information is the stimulus which result in sensation, knowledge and behavior depends upon the senses and their stimulation. The physical senses used by people are vision, hearing, touch, smell and taste. These senses are influenced by a larger number of stimuli, which may be action, information, consideration and feelings, etc., etc. Next one is attention. Stimuli are selectively attended to by people. Some of the stimuli are reacted to while others are ignored without being paid any attention. The stimuli that are paid attention depends purely on the people's selection, capacity and the intensity of the stimuli. Next one is recognition. After paying attention on stimuli, the employee try to recognize whether the stimuli are worth realizing. The messages are incoming stimuli are recognized before they are transmitted into behavior. Perception is a two-phase activity, that is, receiving stimuli and translating the stimuli into action. Translation. The stimuli are evaluated before being converted into action or behavior. Evaluation process is translation. For example, the car driver, after recognizing the stimuli, uses the clutch and brake to stop the car. He has immediately translated the stimulus into an appropriate action. The perception process is purely mental before it is converted into action. The conversion is translation. Next one, behavior. Behavior is the outcome of the cognitive process. If it is a response to change in sensory input, that is, it is an overt and covert responses. The behavior of employees depends upon the perception which is visible in the form of action, reaction or other behavior. And the next one is performance. Proper behavior leads to higher performance. High performers become a source of stimuli and motivation to other employees. A performance reward relationship is established to motivate people. And the last one is satisfaction. Higher performance gives more satisfaction. The level of satisfaction is calculated with the difference in performance and expectation. If the performance is more than the expectations, people are delighted. But when performance is equal to expectation, it results in satisfaction. So this is the and next one, factors influencing perception. Perception is influenced by the perceiver, the object and the situation. The situational factors are physical setting, social setting, organizational setting, and perceives characteristics, need, experience, value, attitude. Individual's perception and the characteristics of the perceived nature, size, appearance and location. There are three important factors influencing the perception set, that is characteristics of the perceiver, characteristics of the perceived, characteristics of the situation. Perceived situation. Characteristics of the perceiver. Under this, needs and motives. Our need pattern plays an important part in how we perceive things. A need is a feeling of discomfort or tension when one thing he is missing something or requires something. Therefore, unsatisfied needs or motives stimulate individuals and may exert a strong influence on their perception. And the next one is self-concept. It indicates how we perceived ourselves, which then influenced how we perceive other and the situation where are in. The more we understand ourselves, the more we able to perceive others too accurately. And next, third one, past experience. Perceptions are often guided by our past experiences. So, person past experiences mold the way he perceives the current situation. And next one, current psychological state. The psychological and emotional states of an individual are likely to influence how things are perceived. And next one, beliefs. A person's beliefs influences his perception to a great extent. Thus, a fact is conceived not on what it is, but what a person believes it to be. Expectations. So, expectations are related with the state anticipation of particular behavior of a person. Next, situation. Elements in the environment surroundings and individuals like time, location, etc. influence his perception. Next one and the last one, cultural upbringing. A person's ethics, values and his cultural upbringings also play an important role in his perception about others. It is difficult to perceive the personality of a person realized in another culture because our judgment is based upon our own values. Next one, characteristics of the perceived. Under this, physical appearance. Characteristic of the person who is being observed can affect that what is perceived, though it may be go against logic and objectivity. But it cannot be defined that our perceptions about other are influenced by other physical characteristics such as appearance, age, gender, manner of communication, as well as personality traits and other forms of behavior. Those are called as physical appearance. Next, similarity. Persons, objectives or events that are similar to each other tend to be grouped together is called as similar. Next, characteristics of the situation. Under this we have two things, that is physical setting and organizational setting. So, physical setting. The context in which वी सी ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर इवेंट्स इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. द सराउंडिंग सराउंडिंग एनवायरमेंट एंड द एलिमेंट प्रेजेंट इन द इन्फ्लुएंस आवर परसेप्शन वाइल परसीविंग द पर्टिकुलर सिचुएशन आर इन्फ्लुएंस इवेंट. एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल सेटिंग्स. इट इज ऑल्सो इफेक्ट द बिहेवियर ऑफ द पीपुल. An organization setting here people are given an opportunity to interact in a friendly and sociable work situations. They become more trustworthy and less defensive. These are the characteristics of the situations. So this is totally is called as a perception.